This is our very first Lunch and Learn of the year, and it's with Cassie. She's going to be talking to us about Kangen Water. She works for a company called Enagic. And I think she's going to be doing some demonstrations over here. So at some point, just direct your attention over here. But she's going to start with her presentation right here. And if you've got any questions, just wait to the end of the presentation, and then we'll get all of those questions answered. I'll just go ahead and turn this over to Cassie.
Okay. Thank you.
You're good to go.
Thank you so much. I have to say I'm the most nervous that I've ever been for a demo. I've done this over 100 times. I'm so nervous, but I saw some familiar faces, so I'm so glad that y'all came. Thank you. Some of you guys I've met around, you know, the area at our different locations. So I went to Colorado and stood in an hour and a half line for this water. My mom told me that there was a special water in Colorado. She lives in Woodland Park, which is at 10,000 feet, and it's like by Colorado Springs. So I was visiting her, and the company that we were visiting only allowed you to carry one jug per person. They were sharing the water because of what it did for them, and just sharing it with the public. So I went in with my jug. We all stood in a single file line, and the whole time I was there, I saw kind of what you're going to see today. There was bottles all over the walls of different waters. Ozarka used to be my absolute favorite. Nestle Pure Life was a go-to at my old company. So I just drank all those waters, and I thought water was just water. Now, my mom has always been holistic. Every morning, she made us drink this orange drink since I was a little kid, and, you know, we just always thought, you know, mom is mom. She's a little crazy because she would never give us an Advil or anything like that. But anyway, so the whole time I was there, I was listening to the people in line and what they were saying to each other about their different stories. And I started to get, you know, just that kind of chill feeling. Whenever I got to the front, the owner explained his story of why he started this store. And I just could not get it out of my head. I have athletic asthma, and whenever I would, you know, go hiking or anything like that, I would need an inhaler. If I was running, you know, or anything like that, my whole childhood, I was on steroids for asthma and all that stuff. It got a little better as I got older, but I noticed while I was there at 10,000 feet, there was no problem. We had wine the night before. We would get up, and we would go hiking for hours, and I felt amazing, so I knew something was up. So whenever I got back, I researched this water and found out that over 45 years, this has been in 191 countries. It's been in the White House since 2003. It has been all the sports teams, you know, a lot of them have it. It's just very well known in the celebrity market, but why didn't we know about it, right? I couldn't find it anywhere close to me. I live, at the time I lived in Euless, I think, but I couldn't find it anywhere. So I decided to step out on faith and quit my jobs. I had two at the time, and start doing this full time. So at the same time, I talked my brother-in-law into that. And so my brother-in-law and I started a little water store. We bought a reverse osmosis water store, and we started giving away this Kangen water down in Joshua, Texas. So that's how it started 3 years ago. We just started giving it to everyone who had been drinking this reverse osmosis for 15 years. A lot of them were really hesitant in drinking the water. They were really pushing back on us. I've been drinking this. This place has passed hands four times. You know, what are you doing and what are you trying to give me? And I would say, okay, you can buy this for 50 cents a gallon or you can try this for free. And finally, they would start trying it. Within 24 hours, some of them would come back with the craziest stories, and we just started seeing miraculous things. Now, I want to say, first thing is that we make no medical claims. We believe that God designed the body to heal itself if given the right tools. Every single cell, I'm sure you know, is made of water. The brain, all the organs are made of water. And water is not what it used to be. So whenever we drink reverse osmosis or different types of waters, which I'm going to show you, research proves that it goes into our stomach, that it does not get dispersed because it is lacking the minerals and the different things that it needs. So it just goes and sits on the stomach, and it starts stripping you of the minerals that it needs to balance. And I've got some slides I'm going to show you. But basically, Dr. Mercola, the World Health Organization, they've all done tests on this reverse osmosis and distilled water, and they've realized that it is stripping the body of minerals every time it is ingested because it has to balance. God made water with calcium, magnesium, potassium, and sodium. So I want to apologize if I make anything even close to a medical claim. I'm not a doctor. I'm just a girl who started giving away free water. But what happened is we started seeing so many crazy things that people wanted to join us. And so we have cryotherapy clinics, nutrition clubs, doctors and different people who we have teamed up with. And we now have locations all over where you can go buy these machines. We install the machines in your home and you can try this water. So I think we have 16 total now locations in the DFW Metroplex where you can go try this water. So it all started in the 1950s. They started doing studies on the Hunza people. Here they are. See how pretty they are. They're 120. They live to 120 to 140 years old, even to this day. And what they found was that their water was hit by lightning so often that the molecules, the molecular structure was being changed. Okay. So the women would stand in, one area where it was really cloudy, and that's where they would collect their water. So they took that back to a lab and they tested that, and they found that it had tons and tons of molecular hydrogen. The molecular structure had been changed, which we'll talk about, and it was able to, neutralize free radicals, and it was just amazing. So they took that and recreated it with titanium and platinum. So these are our machines. It started back in the 60s. I think it was the Germans. They started making big, huge wall-to-wall technology. And then in 1974, the Japanese bought it and started making hospital-grade machines as well as these home-based units. So here you go. This is our lineup. They're all licensed medically in Japan and many countries. Come on in. Come on in, and if you want to grab some food. You can fly out of DFW with a gallon of water. There's a certification you can print, and you can just tell them, this is my, special water, my special medical water, Japanese medical water, and they will let you fly right through and go through security. I've done it so many times with that certification. So in Japan, I thought this was so interesting. Back in the 1960s, there was only 153 people over the age of 100. Once this company came around, there was now one in every four. We need to update this slide because the updated number is that one in every four homes owns one of these devices. I've seen pictures of homes that have cardboard walls and they still have that hooked up to their sink. So now the new number this year is 69,000 people that are over the age of 100. Now America has around 68,000. No, it's 58,000. Around 58,000. But we have over three times the amount of people that Japan does. So the ratio is way off. So here are some hydration options. Who drinks vitamin water, mineral water? They've been selling all of these as water and making us think that they're processing in our body the same. I know y'all know that plastic is a huge issue. There is 60 million plastic bottles are thrown away every single day. Here's a landfill right here. Just look at all that. Have you ever heard of the Pacific Patch, garbage patch? It's like the size, three times the size of Texas or something, filled in the Pacific with plastic. So reverse osmosis, like I said, there's tons of different studies. It creates dead water. It strips minerals from the body. So if you have a huge reverse osmosis system, commercial, and you can add minerals back in, that's okay as long as they're organic minerals. But the home units that are going under your sink are harboring bacteria. They grow black fungus, and that's why they need that little separate cartridge, the post filter, to remove that black fungus. Not good. So not good. Plus, remember, it goes into our stomach and it strips us of minerals. So what is Kangen water and why is it so different? It's high in antioxidants. It has a high pH, naturally pH. We're not adding anything back into the water. So some of the other machines you're going to see, if you look them up, they have a second filter And that second filter, if you break it open, it's filled with sodium bicarbonates, baking soda, different fake organic, inorganic substances like mimicking calcium and stuff. And then the molecular structure has changed. So it's microclustered, which is a new world. So beauty is more than skin deep. Kangen water flushes the body of toxins and acidic waste. Water is supposed to be a propulsion system. Nutrients into the cells, toxins out. If we're drinking reverse osmosis and tap water that's filled with chemicals and it's no longer flushing, what are we doing? We're holding on to all that acid, we're holding on to all those toxins, and we're not flushing like we should. So at the very beginning, you will detox. Whenever you start on this water, you're going to notice major, going to the bathroom and different things. Some people experience headaches, but stay the course, because those people who experience headaches are prone to headaches. And now you might not have those headaches because whatever's in there, is causing those headaches. So increases immunity, supports healthy digestive and elimination, powerful antioxidant, which we'll talk about more. So the number one product sold in the world, it's an electrolysis water generator is the technical term, is this SD501. It has over $1,000 of titanium and platinum in it. So it's lightning in a box. We're able to mimic that process of what was happening with the Hunza people, and they're individually made. There is people that quality test those by hand every single time before they go out. This is the inside of a device. So basically what happens is the tap water goes through the double carbon antibacterial filter, and it removes all the sediment and the rust and, all of that stuff and the chlorine and bacteria. But then the true filtration is done in the titanium and the platinum splitting. See the electrode splitting the plus and the minus charges? So we've got hydrogen, calcium, magnesium going up the alkaline tube, and then all of the trash going down the drain tube. We get asked about fluoride a lot. Fluoride is a huge problem. And fluoride is a chemical and it's a mineral. So the natural occurring mineral fluoride comes in our ground and stuff. There's not a whole lot of that in our water. It is going to get through. So if you need fluoride out of there, you're going to get a separate filter, but it's fluoridic acid that the city is adding back in that is extremely dangerous. And that will 100% go down the drain tube, which you guys can inspect whenever we get over here. So the machine produces 7 different types of pH waters. You just press a button here, and it will change the different pHs, which we'll talk about what those do in just a second. A lot of these I'm just going to skip through because we don't have a ton of time. But if you're a sports fan, it all started with Michael Robinson. They went to the playoffs and then the Super Bowl, and they said, "What do you attest your success to?" And he said, "Kangen water." And all the teams started buying up the machines. So I've personally confirmed that the Texas Rangers and the Dallas Cowboys have the platinum unit in their weight room. Here's some just who's who. I'm not big on who's who, but if you guys are. Now, Magic Johnson, I want to point him out. So y'all all know what he struggles with. He was flying a jet to Tecate, Mexico, which is one of the places that has this restructured water that's hit by lightning. And he now has like 10 machines, I think. So what do doctors have to say about it? The top cardiologist in the country, Gerald Bresnahan, he is the doctor for the Queen of England, the Pope, all these people. And then Jimmy Carter, we're actually on her team, Cynthia. All these people have machines and have since for a long time. I don't want to say exactly because I don't know. I know that they've been in the White House since 2003. But the top colon doctor, has anybody here ever had a colonoscopy? You can thank this guy. So he helped invent the colonoscopy, and he solely invented the method of removing polyps. It's called the Shinya method. And as you can see, we've got before and after colon. He will not treat a patient unless they drink Kangen water, specifically Kangen water, and take his enzymes. And he wrote a book. It's called The Enzyme Factor, if you guys want to snatch that book up. He says in 31 years, he has never seen a reoccurrence of cancer, ever. So, and that was an older book, but here's prostate cancer before and after. This is the colon. This is what the colon looks like after a couple of months. So the root cause of cancer, y'all have probably all heard this. Dr. Otto Warburg, He says all forms of cancer have two basic conditions, acidosis and hypoxia, which is a lack of oxygen. Cancerous tissues are acidic, healthy tissues are alkaline. So deprive a cell 35% of its oxygen for 48 hours and it may become cancerous. This is the American Anti-Cancer Institute. If you want to get the book, it's called Killing Cancer, Not People. They might even have it here. Bob Wright, he has, I think, 96 clinics, American anti-cancer clinics around, and they test everything that's anti-cancer, and this is their list of what helps with cancer. As you can see, alkaline ionized water is number one, and on YouTube, he has tons of different videos where he talks about our brand specifically, and then you can see some of the other stuff. If y'all want to take a picture of this later, you can. But there's other things that I know that they use most of them here because Dr. Katsanis is at the leading edge of, you know, what is for cancer and helping people with cancer. So the number one property of our water isn't the pH. It's not the, you know, I guess it is a molecular structure, but it's the H2. It's the hydrogen that's coming. So we're basically breaking the bond of H2O. And these are some of the health benefits that it's shown. So in 170 disease models, virtually every organ in the body they've had success with. So I want to read this because it's probably a little hard to see. But in a scientific study by the National Institute of Health, it was discovered that the consumption of hydrogen-rich water for 8 weeks resulted in a 39% increase in antioxidant enzyme superoxide dismutase and 43% decrease in thiobarbituric acid reactive substances in urine. Further subjects demonstrated an 8% increase in high-density lipoprotein cholesterol and 13% increase in total cholesterol from baseline to 4 weeks. So just crazy results with H2. Which is molecular hydrogen. And I have a little meter that's going to start testing the antioxidant in a second. But H2 has the capacity to protect DNA, which is why it is effective against lifestyle-related diseases like cancer and heart diseases. So how much do y'all drink? Are y'all big water drinkers now? I see you've got a big, huge jug. Good for you. So the World Health Organization said that just for a healthy person to maintain normal organ function, they need 50% of their body weight in ounces. If you're ill or in the heat or anything like that, you need 75% of your body weight in ounces. So if you weigh 100 pounds, you need 75 ounces, right? If you're chronic, which would be diabetes, you guys know, cancer, anything like that, you need 100% of your body weight in ounces. Now, this can go back. You don't have to drink this all the time, but this is going to be at the beginning whenever you're trying to clean out those cells of toxins. So H2 only scavenges the bad free radicals. Have you ever had a doctor tell you, quit buying antioxidants? If you go to the store right now and you go, you know, look at all of these pills, a lot of them say antioxidants, but they have bad byproducts in the body. The natural byproduct of whenever you have H2, it's selective and it just has free, you know, the free electrons to go. Here's a picture here. So it goes straight to the free radical and it's not messing with any of the other free radicals. And it's not causing more, which is something that we really don't want. So can you get too much molecular hydrogen? Is it safe? A lot of people are so worried about drinking 100 ounces of water, but it's restructured. So no, there is absolutely no toxicity. NASA makes their people drink, I think it was like 3 times their weight. I mean, it's a crazy amount. And on The Biggest Loser, have you ever watched that show? You can see my same machines on the counter whenever they're filming. They make them drink 100% of their body weight in ounces, and there's no problem because you simply just exhale it out. 6 months before and 6 months after NASA, they use this. So now I'm going to start my demonstration in just a second over here. We're going to be moving the camera. But the first property of the water is the molecular hydrogen, which becomes an antioxidant. So I have a meter and I'm going to be able to test whether these drinks are oxidizing the body or an antioxidant. So the American Cancer Society said that cancer turns on at about positive 30 in the cell when the polarity changes. It's about a positive 30. We've got all these different drinks that are in the positives. So negative is good and positive is bad, okay? Green tea, you can see it's a negative 80. So we're going to go over here and test all these popular beverages and see if they are oxidizing or not. So if we'll direct our attention over here. How are you? Make sure that you can see. So who drinks tap water? Anyone? We're going to do a test on all of these. This is from just grapevine tap, I guess. Essentia. Now, this is a really popular drink. Do you want me to keep holding? I need to just fill up the drinks. But Essentia, this is 9.5. Essentia. This is a very, very popular thing. And now all of the different brands are jumping on board, adding things to their water to change the pH because they don't want to lose their profits. And people start switching. So this is crazy water. Now, do y'all know about mineral wells? I will never bash this water. It's a go-to for me if I can't get to Kangen Water. This is a natural well out in Mineral Wells. It is super mineral rich. We went and visited them, and we tested their water, okay? So straight from the well, it was a negative 50 charge. It was alive. It was awesome. But then they fill the tanks, and then they fill the bottles. And those tanks were already at a positive 200 charge. And we're going to show you that. And then let's see what happens whenever you bottle it. So this is Crazy 3 water, which, like I said, I'll never bash them. I love what they do. And they're just a really sweet family-owned company. So Dasani, this is Coca-Cola's product. I don't know if you know, but they make more money on this than they do any of their beverages, probably some of them combined. So I want you to hear that. You hear that? This did not start like that. The water is so unstable that it's searching for minerals and eating that plastic. So what about Aquafina? This is Pepsi's product. Did y'all know that? This is Pepsi's product. And then Ozarka, which says natural spring water. Now, I just want to point out that the FDA does not require them to actually put the real origin of the water on the bottle. It can be from anywhere. Does anybody do LaCroix? Okay, so I've personally talked to people who know that, you know, the water's out of the tap and they're saying it's from Canada or, you know, all these different places, but it's not illegal. And the girl who manages all bottled water companies in the United States has other jobs. She's gone on record. You can't manage all that as one person. What about Gatorade? This is a go-to for kids, and this is going to represent any Propel or vitamin water or anything like that, and then soda. We do a dye test in a minute, so that's why we use the clear. But let's see. So I have a meter, and it's going to scavenge. It's going to go out there and see if we have electrons or whether we have a whole bunch of protons. So I need to get it calibrated really quick. Oh, let's pour the Kangen water. So I bottled this from my house, okay? So that was how many hours ago? So I want you to know that light, air, and movement break down water. Electrons go into the air, so that's why I have it in the glass, and I have a tight lid on it, because we want to keep that, you know, contained. So let me see. So let's start with the tap water. Okay, so I'm going to let it calibrate and go up. Can you see the number? Okay, so I'm going to let you guys be my Vanna Whites because we're videoing over here. So do you see what's happening? It keeps rising. This is tap water. We're at, what are we at? 327, 334. It's still rising. Now remember, plus 30, the American Cancer Society says, the polarity in the cell. So we don't want anything going in that could be stealing our electrons, right? If it's positive, it's unstable, and it's going in and causing free radicals. So we're in the 350s. We don't have to keep going. Let's try Essentia. So it went down a little. Essentia went down a little. Let's let it stop. So it stopped at 252. Now, how much did this cost? $3 a bottle almost, right? This is the most expensive thing that you can buy out there. I mean, it is so expensive. And then let's do crazy water, which I hate to test sometimes because I don't want to bash them, but it's at 363. So water breaks down straight from the well. You can get it, you know, at a negative 50. Now let's go to Dasani. So Dasani went down a little. And it really just means, you know, this might have been in the heat more. This might have been bottled a lot longer ago. You know, it just depends on that. So Aquafina, it just rise. So we're at 370, 390. You see that? 400. We just went over 400. This is Aquafina. Now, if you go on YouTube and type in Aquafina construction site, you'll see a video of a construction site and all of the water bottles froze over that night. They videoed it. But the Aquafina bottles did not freeze. Why did the water not freeze? It's not water. It is not water. So let's test Ozarka. So it's going down a little, see? So if I had a choice, I would choose Ozarka over Aquafina, right? But sometimes we test them and the other one is higher. It just depends on how much they sat in the gas station parking lot, you know? So we're at 440. What about LaCroix? See what just happened in the meter? 540. Uh-oh. Mixed it up. So Gatorade, 560. Soda went down. So Gatorade was higher than the soda. So we've got the soda. It's going down. It's at about, let's move it around so we can get it. So it looks like it's going to go under 500. 502. I hate to stop it, but for time purposes, we've got to go down. If it was anywhere in the 300s, it would have shot down. So it's just going to probably sit in the 490s, okay? So let me wash off my meter here. And we're going to test the Kangen water, the star of the show. Now, this is electrically reduced water if you're researching it. Now, what happened to the meter? Can y'all see this? What does it say? Still rising. Negative 700. You see that? So our body makes a brand new cell at about negative 50. So that's why green tea is so great. Juicing, cold press juicing. That's how I met Susie here at Rejuve Juice Bar. That's a negative 100 charge. So that's why people see miraculous results, because they're making new healthy cells. But we're at negative 790, and I bottled this hours ago. If I tested the water in my jug, which, here, I'm going to test this water. So this has been sitting out. I poured this for you guys. This has been sitting out for a little while. The electrons in the H2 has now escaped the cup. And what are we at? If I move it around, it finds electrons. You see that? So if I move it around, but it went to a zero if I leave it still, or about a negative 30. This was poured at the same time that my other water was poured this morning. But I just want you to see that water breaks down. So the important thing is to get it straight from the machine, negative 800, just down it all the time. Just think about how many negative healthy cells you can make. So crazy, right? Y'all can ask any questions if you want. Is it going to mess you up if we just switch over here real quick? Because I'm going to come back here. But let me just change my slide. That is the oxidation reduction potential, the ORP. So basically the ability to oxidize you, the potential to oxidize you or to become an antioxidant in the body. That's the ORP is the meter that I have. An ORP meter. So let's see if water is just water. We'll skip this slide. So research proves that 1 16-ounce glass of electrically reduced water from a Kangen water device is equivalent to 20,000 blueberries. 5 pounds of blueberries. There's nothing else that you can touch. And as far as the H2, it's equivalent to consuming 516 apples, 756 bananas, and 38 carrots. Now, once I saw this number, it made me want to eat a lot of carrots. I don't like carrots, but the ratio is crazy, right? That is a lot of antioxidants in a carrot. So eat more carrots. But anywho, I just thought that was so crazy. So, but you have to get it fresh because as you saw, the water will break down. It will lose its life. It'll lose that molecular hydrogen. So now we're going to talk about alkaline versus alkalizing, okay? People are adding different chemicals. If I switch back over here, I'm going to show you. Now the city adds lye, L-Y-E, which is a detergent. Have y'all ever seen that movie, Throw Mama from the Train with Danny DeVito? He tries to kill his mama with lye. He puts lye in her soda and then he chickens out. Lye parts per million too much will kill you, but a little bit will just change the pH of our water because the government mandates that it be from like a 7.3 to a 7.6 because if it was Ozarka or tap or, you know, Dasani, it would eat the pipes. So they have to keep that alkalinity up, and that's why they add a 14 pH. We have confirmed that with the municipalities. So ammonia, different phosphates. So here's a pH chart. Our blood is always going to be the same. 7.365 is about where it falls, and if that falls too far above and too high, we will just die, okay? You can't really mess with the pH of the blood, but the tissue will change. So I've got this slide. If the blood develops a more acidic condition, then these excess acidic waste have to be deposited somewhere in the body. If this unhealthy process continues year after year, these areas steadily increase in acidity and their cells begin to die. So this is a prostate. Just think about a prostate. The cells are dying. Other cells in the affected area may survive by becoming abnormal. These are called malignant. Malignant cells cannot respond to brain commands. They undergo a cellular division that is out of control, and this is the beginning of cancer. So, modern medicine treats this malignant cells as if they were bacteria and viruses. It uses chemotherapy, radiation, and surgery to treat cancer, yet none of these treatments will help very much if the environment of the body continues to remain acidic. So you have to change the environment. You have to put something in your body that depletes the acidity. So our water, you can drink loads and loads of it, and it will never mess with the blood pH. Our water is electrolyzed reduced. And so what that means is through reduction, your body will become alkaline, okay? So it's going to go in, it's going to bring nutrients into the cells, toxins out, and therefore alkalinity is the byproduct, okay? Because we're not adding anything into the water. We're using high electricity to split acid and alkaline. And so you've got minerals and H2 that then clean out the cells. Does that make sense? We're not adding any baking soda, no lye. We're not changing the pH of the water. The alkalinity is a natural byproduct. So here's the acidosis process. Eat and drink, acidic substances, little or no exercise, poor digestion, poor bowel elimination. And then that comes down to tissues and organs. They become acidic and rob calcium from the bones. To neutralize acidity, calcium deposits develop in fatty acidic tissues and your breasts. Bones are shorted of calcium, weak, brittle, porous bones. And then now we've got all this stuff that came down the line. Poor health, chronic illness, cancer, osteoporosis, arthritis. So if we can get the body back into balance by reducing the acid out of the body, we've seen some crazy things. I'm 36 years old. I'm pregnant. I just I have a two-year-old and I'm 17 weeks pregnant right now. And I have not had one bout of throwing up or anything. That is crazy. My friends are in their 20s puking up to 9 months. The baby steals the alkalinity from the mom. It is going to be born in alkaline. We are alkaline beings. And so unless we put things in our body that can reduce the acidity, we're kind of screwed. But you've got the 20,000, you know, blueberries that you can eat or drink and help you feel better. So let's go back to the pH chart and we're going to test the pH of these drinks. We need a couple technical minutes so we can change the camera over. So tell me when you're ready. Do you know what time it is? 15 till, okay. Thank you. Ready? Okay. So these are pH drops, just like what you would use in your pool. We're just going to see if these are alkaline or acidic, okay? So we already talked about tap. We've got a 14 pH being added to it to change that pH. Now let's look at Essentia real quick. The ingredients, which water should not have ingredients, are, it says purified by reverse osmosis. Then it has sodium bicarbonate, baking soda basically, dipotassium phosphate, magnesium sulfate, and calcium chloride, and electrolytes for taste. That's all added to this water. So what happens? We got kidney stones. We got all sorts of things. You can't add all these inorganic substances into the body because it doesn't know how to use them. So right now, if I had nothing else, I would drink it. But I wouldn't want that to build up in my body. Now, crazy water is just crazy water from the well. Trace minerals. Okay? So that's organic minerals. And then Dasani, Aquafina, we're going to test them all. Ready? So let's see. Here's Kangen Water. Tap, which is neutral. So green is a neutral. Blue is alkaline. They said that it's a 9.5, and it looks like it is. Here's the crazy water. It is definitely alkaline with the blue. Now check that out. You see the orange? That is a 5 pH. 5 pH. What about the Aquafina? 5 pH. Ozarka? 5 pH. Now this chart isn't really that great because a 2.5 pH is also orange with these. So if I tested this with a pH meter, the LaCroix would be about a 2.63 pH. Let me switch these. Now we've got Gatorade. It's showing to be about a 4.5, but like I said, whenever I do it with a meter, it's less. And then a soda, so 2.5. Now, the pH scale is not a one-point scale. So if I drink a 7.365, that's neutral. 7 is a neutral, right? But if I drink a 6, that is 10 times more acidic than neutral. If I drink a 5, that's 100 times more acidic. If I drink a 4, that's 1,000 times more acidic. So if we get down in the 2s, we are 100,000 times more acidic than a neutral. Your body is constantly fighting. So what happens is it eats minerals. It goes in, it starts taking, you know, calcium, magnesium, different alkaline minerals and trying to become alkaline. So let's just see if we can try to bring these back, okay? So we're going to add a little bit of minerals into Dasani. See what happens. See how quickly we can get that back up? What about the Aquafina, which is bubbly? Do you see the bubbles on the side? Why is Aquafina bubbly? So we can just add some minerals, right? What about the Ozarka? It didn't take much. Just a little capful of mineral water and we're back up. Let's try the LaCroix. Do you see it trying to change? But the acid takes over. Acid eats minerals. No, it didn't even try to change on this. The Sprite. So I just want to correct myself. The Sprite didn't change at all. I bet that's not a 2.5. I know these are a 2.5 pH, but I would assume this is about a 4.5 because it tried to change. But we did a test on our Facebook, Texas Water Supply. You can go to our Facebook, Texas Water Supply. And it took us a five-gallon jug of water. We could not get one soda to neutral. 5 gallons. They say it's a 36-to-1 ratio, but that's a lot, right? And then the Gatorade, it took 5 gallons to get it to neutral. So it got about a 6.5 on the soda and then there. So let's just say that I am really craving a little bit of fizz, okay? Well, I've tried to change my life. I'm going to stop drinking this stuff, but once a week I'm going to have my fizz. Let's just see what happens. I'm going to drink my, and remember this is diluted with soda. So do you see how the it's eating the minerals? So it has to become stable. I mean, the body is a perfect, you know, this is just a representation of it, but the body is perfect. It has to become stable. So let's try Gatorade. Oh, I spilled. So this is what we're sending our kids out on the football field. It says electrolytes on the bottle. Now, let me just point out that it is not required by the FDA for there to still be electrolytes in the bottle. If they started out with electrolytes and then the other substances ate it, that's okay. They can still put it on the bottle. So there is no presence of electrolytes, which is just sodium, right? But anyway, completely destroyed. I'm going to show you. So I'm going to try to bring my water back. And we can even try to bring the tap water back. So do you see what happens? It's just still dropping. And that was just a cap full of diluted soda. It's very hard to bring it back. So just try. I mean, oh my gosh, if you could just go some time, 3 weeks, you know, 4 months without putting this stuff in your body, just think about how much your body would thank you. So the third property is that the molecular structure has been changed. So whenever all the acid is removed, the molecules become so much smaller. And we know that H2 or hydrogen is the smallest molecule already, right? So research proves that Kangen water goes to your brain in 60 seconds and all of the organs in about 12 minutes. So I'm going to just, this is a silly, just a little representation, but I've got these green tea bags, and normally you have to boil tea to get into a tea bag, or you have to boil the water. So let's just see. Here's some Kangen water. And then, what's your favorite beverage? We've got a Dasani here. So I'm gonna race with these tea bags. Lipton green tea. Does anybody like Lipton green tea? You don't have to boil your water anymore. You ready? So we're going to race. Go. So do you see that we're already making tea over here? So a regular water molecule is about 15 to 20 cluster. That's what we see here with the bulk water. It has to be boiled in order for it to mix. So let's take these and let's just see. I'm going to try with my water to try to see if I can help it out. Hopefully y'all can see this on the camera. But do you see what just happened? So you saw a discoloration from me making tea, you know, from dropping it in there, but it was just floating. It wasn't even mixing with the tea because the molecular structure was too large. So once it goes through the device, it becomes a hexagonal shape, and it is about a 3 to 6 cluster instead of a 15 to 20. So we kind of, just to make a silly representation, we say that if you try to take a softball, a whole bunch of softballs, and push that through a chain link fence, that's like regular water, trying to get that through your cells. You got to bend. I mean, it's really hard to get that through. We're not absorbing water like we should. But once we get up to the 8.5 water on our machine, we're at marbles, ping pong balls, about ping pong balls, and then it goes up to marbles at the 9.5. Are you okay if we switch back to the slide real quick? We're not going to be on it long because I'm going to come back over here. So we already met Hiromi Shinya. He uses it in, and that's another book that is really good, The Microbe Factor. So we talked about the drinking water, but I want to show you really quick the other waters that this machine produces. There's one that is so acidic that it kills bacteria. This is huge for, you know, wounds and different things like that. It is certified medically, even here in the U.S. We've got a high alkaline water. So the strong alkaline water, the 11.5 pH, is for cleaning. You're going to use it as a degreaser for your stove. You're going to use it as a veggie wash, makeup remover, stain remover, laundry cleaner, and it's really good for brushing your teeth because the molecular structure is so small that it can penetrate and emulsify even oils. So I'm going to do a little test back over here, and we're going to do a taste test on some vegetables. Because did y'all know, well, I hate switching back to the slide. You can see both or, okay. So on the slide, the EPA now allows you to consume up to 30 times more pesticides and herbicides than we were before. In 2012, they raised it from this little amount to that big, huge amount. Now, if you walk into a bar and have a shot, you're okay. But after 60 ounces, you've got skin conditions, study issues, respiratory problems. I mean, we cannot be having that much chemical overload in our body. So we're going to, I bought organic and regular because I want to show you that whenever it comes to pesticides, there's not a humongous difference. The organic pesticide list consists of 1,500 substances. So they are allowed to put up to 1,500 approved chemicals on it. Some of them probably aren't too damaging, but I would imagine some of them are. So these are the organic. See, it says Simple Truth, organic grape tomatoes. It's non-GMO and USDA organic. And then we've got some cherubs. Does anybody buy cherubs? This is probably the most popular brand sold around here, I think. Does that look even? You want to be fair. Maybe one more. Okay, so this is my 11.5 water that I bottled from my machine this morning. And I'm just going to pour it. I'm going to show you that it is just water, okay? Just water. Let me get another cup so we don't. So let me pour some in here. And then we're going to wash these other ones with just anything. Uh-oh, much. But while these brew, do y'all remember the left is Kangen 11.5 and then the other two are, while these brew, I'm going to show you what happens or what is happening. So basically the water molecule is too big to mix with oils. We learned that in science class, right? So I've got some sesame oil here and we're going to see if that's still true. Oh, that's way too much. Normally it's like a little tiny hole. Does that look even? About? Okay, so let's just take Ozarka, because I don't have much water. What happens to oil and water normally? So if y'all can see on camera, we've got all the oil right up at the top, beaded up. Let's see what happens with Kangen water. Remember, this is our 11.5. See that? So water and oil do mix. It totally milked up and met with every, so I can pass it around or y'all can come up and look at it later. But the molecules are so teeny tiny. I mean, we talked about the BBs, you know, going through the fence. That's going through the oil. So that's why we're able to remove these pesticides, because pesticides are oil-based so that the rain won't wash them off. It's very expensive to take an airplane and fly it over a field. If they have to do that every time it rains, that's going to cost a farmer a lot of money. So I want you guys to try these. And I think they have a couple of hundred people watching online. So we'll hopefully get a few of you going, ooh, gross, or something like that. Okay, so we have organic here. No, the little ones are organic. Little ones are organic. So these are cherubs. Let's just see what came off. Now, farmers are also getting kind of smart because they know we're doing these tests, I think. They used to make them really, really yellow, and now they're using clear pesticides. But you can still taste the difference. Okay, so let's see if anything came off. This is the bottled water tomatoes. Do y'all see that? You can kind of see the color. But let's try these first. You don't like them? Oh, you're fasting. Okay. These are the Kangen tomatoes. Pass one back. So I'm going to let you pass those. Now try this one. Yeah. Those are cherubs. Yeah, cherub. A little rubbery.
Yeah.
What'd you notice? Different taste? You notice anything? A lot of people don't like tomatoes. They tell me they don't like tomatoes, but after they try the first one, they're like, this ain't so bad, because it's that gross stuff on it. So these are the organic, the little teeny tiny ones. I'll confirm it, see how tiny they are. Little tiny organic tomatoes. So I want you to guys to see, here's the Aquafina. See what came off? So this is the organic tomatoes. Both of these are from Kroger. I picked them up this morning. Oh, you're not doing it. This is the good ones. And then this is the other ones. So I'm sure we'll get the same results, but I just want you to know that that's a big difference. But this is organic, and they make us think, you know, that it's just so sad. But if I paid somebody to drink this, they wouldn't do it. But yet this is what we are eating, you know, every single time. Our kids, everybody is drinking this or eating this. Like I said, organic approved, they have 1,500 approved pesticides. So what you're going to do is you're going to get home from the grocery store. You're going to put all of your fruits and vegetables in the 11-5. I just fill up a sink and just put them all in there. You know, some of them, like blueberries, I would leave them in the container where they're not all over the place, and just let them, you know, pull them out. And but this stuff is oxidizing your fruits and vegetables, and so your fruits and vegetables will last 1 to 3 weeks longer now that you get these chemicals off. Now, we stuck our probe. Remember, this probe is looking for the oxidation reduction potential, the ability to oxidize you. We stuck this in an organic apple, and it had a positive 400 charge. Positive 400. But I can stick this in an apple and then put the apple in my 11-5 water, which, remember, has a negative charge. It's filled with electrons, and restore that fruit. So I've got some pictures that I'll show you here. We're going to switch back to this really quick. So this is just the 9-5 water with the negative water. Look at this. The celery was damaged, totally dying, and after a couple of hours, it came back to life. So we were able to save that celery and eat that celery because of those, you know, because of the electrons in there being able to restore it. If you like to grow plants, you would not believe how much healthier they grow with this water. We have, what was I going to say? Well, we've done this study ourselves, but we've done all kinds of different growing ones. Here's the beauty water. So if I press this beauty button, It's going to make a 6 pH, which is the perfect pH for your skin and hair. So it's going to tighten and tone your skin. You can get rid of all of your toners. There are beauty salons selling this for over $10 a bottle because all they're doing is changing the pH by adding chemicals to water, where we have the perfect pH. And it detangles your hair. It's just wonderful. So as you can see, these bottles are being sold at different places. And all it is water. Perfect pH water. Now, my favorite water is the 2.5 because I have a 2-year-old and she is messy. So this is the 2.5 water. All of you guys at the end, I'd love for you to stay and smell this. It smells like kind of like a bleach, like a chlorine, but all it is water and salt. So this machine makes unlimited amounts with the salt solution of this strong acid water. The medical term for it is hypochlorous acid, and it actually helps with the restoration of skin. My baby had double pink eye, killed it, all these things. I mean, it kills strep throat, salmonella. You know, right now there's a big scare with the lettuce, so you can just spray it with the 2.5 and you don't have to worry about the E. coli on your lettuce. It will kill it. Mold, just basically anything it will kill. So overseas in hospitals, they've been using this for bed stores. They've been using this for everything, the 2.5. No creams, you know, no, nothing like that, because like I said, it helps with the restoration. I'm going to show you some pictures here. So here's some before and after different psoriasis. We've got eczema. So this is with the 2.5. And look at this guy. He had this flesh-eating disease for 5 years. They could not. I mean, they tried everything, steroids and antibiotics and everything. And then after the use of the 2.5, he was able to finally get it to close up. So give this to your pets. It's 100% safe. If you want to do an experiment, you can give your pets the 8.5, the 9, and the 9.5, and they'll choose for themselves. So based on their breed or their weight, they'll choose what they need. But most animals are just okay with the 9.5 that we drink. We had a guy in Burleson buy a machine from us. He raised his chickens solely on tap and then the other set solely on Kangen water. The chickens are not sore by making these big eggs because they grew like 4 times the size of their peers. The neighbors called, his name is Norris. Norris, the dogs are getting your chickens. And he's like, that's just my other chickens. They're huge, huge, huge. Too fast to take pictures of them, I guess. So what is your health worth? I was talking to, is it Charlie? No. Chad. I was talking to Chad earlier. We were talking about the amount of the machines. You know that you're going to spend a whole lot of money whenever you get sick. You know, we all do. You know, whenever something happens to us, we've got to take care of it. I'm not ever going to say that it's prevention or anything, but the body is made of water and we have to put the right water in there. So you can have unlimited amounts of drinking water, cleaning waters, all those type of waters straight from this machine. They last up to 20 years. These are just some things that you might spend your money on. But investing in one of these is definitely changing my life. This is our lineup. They've got an under-the-counter unit and different units, but the number one machine in the whole world sold is this SD501 series, and we have different programs where you can finance it and stuff like that. It comes in the platinum because some people wanted it to match their stainless steel appliances. So we have financing and different things. So 15 to 20 years time span, I want to talk about that. So this company is 45 years old. They still have machines in the field. They know this lifespan by the amount of time they've lasted. We broke it down, and in 20 years, it costs about 50 cents a day, you know, to be able to have this device, which I spend, you know, would have spent more on that and on just a bottle of water. So we have had... right now at my Joshua store, and we have other stores, like I said, we have 16 locations. You've seen it where tons of people are coming in, filling their jugs. We've had 1 to 3 hour line for the water. And sometimes we'll just stop seeing Charlie or whoever it is. So we just won't see them anymore. And we'll be like, wonder what happened to them. And they go online and they become this internet expert and they find this machine that's $1,000 less and they buy it. 3 months later, we see them again with their jugs coming back to get water because they are duping us. Remember I talked to you about that second filter? It has sodium bicarbonates in it. The machines are clogging. They don't have a cleaning where you can clean the machines. We have a cleaning that comes with it. And then these are their titanium plates. So we have so much titanium and platinum in there. And those are some of our competitors. And I tell you not to become an internet expert. Let Bill Gates do the work. He has Asperger's, which is a form of autism. And he started doing all these tests and talking with our people. They got all the competitive units. They tested them, they put them side by side, and they chose the Enagic unit as the golden standard. And he now owns 46 machines and spoke at our conference a few years back. So we just have tons of power, continuous power. The other ones are going up and down. And then the warranty is awesome. And then it's a 100% write-off. So anybody that wants to stay behind that has questions about that, I can explain it. You just got to share water with a few people because the company doesn't allow you to sell it. So share water with your loved ones and you can write it off. You can write off, you know, everything every year like the filters and stuff like that. And then if you refer people, you know, they send you a thank you check. But that's basically it. If y'all have any questions, we'll take those now. I'm so thankful for you guys staying. Like I said, I was so nervous, but I think it hopefully it went okay.